the art of leading ourselves post-pandemic is very important, as Nandu mentioned, that how are we going to deal with this crisis? So I'm pretty much involved in this post-COVID. How are we going to lead post-COVID? So, you know, we all know that there has been an absolutely unanticipated crisis that has transformed almost every facet of global supply chains across industries. And but however, I feel that the comprehension of wellness and health has gotten better understood during these times. And we also somewhere understand that everybody, including millennials, might need to modify their lifestyles, focusing more on their physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual areas of their life. In fact, I've seen some industry experts putting firm bets on wellness becoming more pertinent for most of the population than ever before. So no sugarcoating here. Let's just understand that only a healthy and a strong workforce can be productive for us in the coming times. And it is important for leaders also to know that their teams post-COVID need to be inspired in a certain way. And I myself have suggested many inspiring actions to certain organizations and their C-plus levels. The key questions that I was asked during these times by leaders across organizations were, what are going to be the requirements of the reopening phase? How are we going to get people back? How are we going to retain people? What are the ongoing communications like? What is going to be the strategy to share inspiring news going forward? And for all this, I somewhere realized that integrated wellness, which is a holistic way to understand wellness now, because, you know, wellness has always been seen from the light of only having a nice body or just you know, going to the gym, and COVID made us realize that probably wellness is more to do with that. We saw people getting into fear, we saw people getting depressed, we saw domestic violence, we saw people getting scared. So definitely wellness is got to do with something more than just your physical wellness. So the key point here is resistance to change. My experience of 25 years of coaching leaders, of coaching organizations, talking to universities, talking to the millennials, has been that every human being has somewhere always resisted change. Whenever there is a change, there has been a resistance. And reasons could be anything. Reasons could be old habits. You know, we get so habitual to our routine. It could be comfort zones. It could be we not able to explore anything new because we like to operate out of our comfort zones. It could be fear of new targets. It could be competence. It could be anything like more work, bringing more uncertainty, working with new people. So any kind of a change has always been resisted. And it's not just COVID, but we've seen it from the time we were growing up. Changing your classrooms, changing of your teachers, changing of bosses. Any kind of a change, changing of countries, changing of roles, change has always been resisted. COVID has kind of just brought it up to us and said, okay, here you are. We're just dealing with it head on, all of us. Well, leadership is about change, and leaders now need to navigate this change in a more effective way. So this is where we talk of sustainable leadership, we talk of futuristic leadership, we talk of effective leadership. And leaders, while navigating their teams and employees through these post-COVID times, need to be more, need to tap into their emotional quotient, need to be more generous, need to be more honest, need to be more transparent. and also minimize the discomfort that their employees or their teams could be facing right now. So here is where my spiritual wellness or integrated wellness programs come into play, where I work on the mindsets and the belief systems of people, and we often like to handle them in a way where there is a transformation happening. So it's not just an impact, it's like a transformation, and they get to transform their negativities or their incompetencies, and we have seen results where they are more productive. And this might include processes and lessons around meditations, where you get to understand that you can multitask better if you're in meditation. Teams meditate and they can handle too many things at the same time. It could be yoga at workplace, it could be mindfulness sessions, it could be one-on-one sessions, team sessions, a lot of exciting food habits, sleep habits that we tell teams to inculcate in their daily routine, which makes them more productive and of course more positive and calmer and you know, things like that. There's one thing also here which I would like to mention, because I come from the subtle side, and having my doctorate degree in spiritual sciences, where I have combined two things together, which is the gross and the subtle. And I like to say here that nature is dualistic. We find nature in two forms. One is gross and one is subtle. And gross is very easy for us to comprehend, because gross is something which we can make sense of, you know. For example, if I was to give an example here, gross is like a target, like the number target that we have, something that we can see on the physical level. But what we tend to ignore is the subtle aspect of nature, which is what do we need to fulfill that target? The need to fulfill that target comes from that human being's energy, which he will put in to fulfill the target. So we often tend to ignore the subtle side, wherein I feel that most of us all the time are actually dwelling only into the subtle side of nature. We are always thinking, we are always in some kind of a feeling, in some kind of emotion. It could be positive, it could be negative, anything. So while we understand the gross to be very, very important, and but subtle is something which makes it more important. It's something which drives us to achieve the gross. Just a very small example. You go to a doctor and he gives you a medicine, which is the gross aspect, and you might get healed, but that might leave you with some side effects also. But when I have worked with employees and leaders of various organizations, I have seen that, and with my research on brain plasticity and psychoneuroimmunology, I have seen that when you do subtle work on a person, you tend to transform any kind of illness, or even a chronic illness or a disease or anything, and you're left with no side effect. So what I essentially do is that I work with human beings, because at the end of the day, whoever you are, at whatever level you're working, you're a human being at the end of the day. You're the same flesh and blood, and you have a gross and a subtle side to yourself. So I work on the subtle side, where I try and put all the energies of a person in place. I transform the emotion. I try and ensure that a person is absolutely positive and ready to face any kind of a crisis in his life, which of course is going to make him more productive on the gross level. So post-COVID, we are all worried about the new normal, and we are preparing for the new order now. We are all set, but there's still a lot of uncertainty, because we just don't know how it's going to turn out. So through this platform, through Wintelligence, I truly appreciate that as much as importance is being given to the business side and to everything else, there's an equal importance now coming for wellness, an integrated wellness program. And like Mala said, that I work on an eightfold level. I work on all levels, right from food to sleep to your everything. And and that's what I ensure. And I've worked for 25 years, and we've seen great results And I've also seen that people not only have dropped their diseases and got healed from their chronic illnesses, but they have transformed as people. They have become more positive. They have become more adaptable. So adaptability is something which we might need as the most important asset post-COVID times. So here I am, and thank you so much. I'm glad I could finish on time, because this was tougher than the TED platform where we get 20 minutes.